Notre Dame, man, check that out. I heard the story once about when the Germans were occupying Paris and they had to retreat back. They wired Notre Dame to blow, you know, but they had to leave one guy in charge of hitting the switch, and the guy, the soldier, he couldn't do it. You know, he just sat there, knocked out by how beautiful the place was. And then when the Allied troops came in, they found all the explosives just lying there, and the switch unturned, and they found the same thing, the Sacré-Cœur, Eiffel Tower, a couple other places, I think.
Is that true?
I don't know. I always liked the story, though.
Yeah, that's a great story. But you have to think that Notre Dame will be gone one day. I mean, there used to be another church or cathedral at the same, right there.
Oh, right in the same spot?
Yeah. Hmm. Yeah, this is great. I've never done this.
Yeah.
I forget about how beautiful Paris is.
That's not so bad being a tourist, huh?
Thank you for getting me on the boat.
Oh, you're welcome. You know, I think that book that I wrote, in a way, was like building something. So that I wouldn't forget the details of the time that we spent together. You know, like just as a reminder that once we really did meet, you know, that this was real, this happened.
I'm happy you're saying that because, I mean, I always feel like a freak because I'm never able to move on like this, you know. People just have an affair or even entire relationships. They break up and they forget. They move on like they would have changed brand of cereals. I feel I was never able to forget anyone I've been with. Because each person has their own specific qualities. You can never replace anyone. What is lost is lost. Each relationship, when it ends, really damages me. I never fully recover. That's why I'm very careful with getting involved, because it hurts too much. Even getting laid, I actually don't do that. I will miss of the person the most mundane things. Like, I'm obsessed with little things. Maybe I'm crazy, but when I was a little girl, my mom told me that I was always late to school. One day she followed me to see why. I was looking at chestnuts falling from the trees, rolling on the sidewalk, or ants crossing the road, the way a leaf casts a shadow on a tree trunk. Little things. I think it's the same with people. I see in them little details so specific to each of them that move me and that I miss and will always miss. You can never replace anyone because everyone is made of such beautiful, specific details.